Now, here's your Farm and Ranch Report from the Montana Ag Network.
Welcome back for today's Farm and Ranch News. In our headlines today, USDA's Farm Service Agency just last week issued a notice to state and county offices on making direct and guaranteed loans to hemp producers for the 2021 growing season and then abruptly pulled back that notice. The original notice indicated that hemp growers could no longer produce the crop under the pilot program that was part of the 2014 Farm Bill. However, the agency quickly withdrew the guidance, noting the Continuing Appropriations Act of 2021 and other extensions act authorizes operations to continue to produce hemp from approved Farm Bill pilot programs until September 30th, 2021. Now, given that extension in the continuing resolution, FSA said additional guidance on making direct and guaranteed loans to hemp producers for the 2021 crop year is still forthcoming. Looking to Montana's crop progress report today, the sugar beet harvest progressed well this past week, with an estimated 36% of the crop harvested behind the five-year average of 41%. Planting of the 2021 winter wheat crop also continues to make way, behind average though, with an estimated 77% of the crop planted. Emergence of the winter wheat crop in the state advanced last week, with an estimated 57% of the crop emerged behind the five-year average of 60%. Now, as we look to other news now, two meat industry groups are urging the Department of Agriculture to support mandatory labeling of cell-based cultured meat and poultry products or imitation fake meats. The Meat Institute and the Alliance for Meat, Poultry, and Seafood Innovation penned the request in a letter to USDA on Monday. The groups also call on USDA to solicit input on what that labeling should look like through the advance notice of public rulemaking. That the two agencies should work together to ensure the safety and labeling of cell-based cultured meat and poultry products that also does not mislead consumers. We'll be right back.